Hare Krishna. To see our own stupidity, unvarnished and unjustified, is infuriating and invigorating. Now, to see our own stupidity means that we often do stupid things. We give in to short-sighted urges, speak things which we shouldn't speak, indulge in actions, pleasures, which are against our principles, which can cost us a lot in various terms, but we unfortunately keep indulging in them. And amid such indulgence, we often keep doing it without really acknowledging to even to ourselves what to speak of to the world that we are doing it. So at such times, our intelligence is also taken away by desire, by the stupid indulgences. But sometimes our intelligence awakens. So normally our intelligence puts varnishes and justifications on what we are doing. That means that with the intelligence, we put a justification. Actually, everyone is doing it. We put a varnish. Actually, I'm doing this, but it is also good. Something good will come out of it. It's not that bad. So when we varnish something, we make it look better. When we rationalize, justify something, we try to defend it. So now there are times when our stupidity becomes apparent to us in its naked ugliness. So for example, say we keep smoking and just saying it's just fashionable. It's no big deal. I only smoke occasionally. Or if we drink occasionally, they say it's no big deal. But then suppose we get lung cancer. Suppose in being drunk, we drive and we get ourselves into big trouble. Say we hit into someone. We, because of intoxication, we can't control our vehicle and we get ourselves into trouble. Then we are brought face to face with our stupidity. So why did I do that? And such a moment is infuriating. We can rail at the world. We can rail at ourselves. We can rail at others. But at such times, if it's infuriating, that is good. Because in that, when we are angry with ourselves, anger is a very powerful emotion. And it can be channeled destructively or constructively. It's only when we feel that a particular situation is unacceptable, intolerable, unconscionable. And all this happens when we confront our stupidity. When we understand how much time, energy I wasted on this. How much I have given up for my refusal to give up some petty indulgence. How much I have lost. Then that is infuriating, but it is also invigorating. Invigorating means that now no more. I am not going to succumb to this anymore. I am going to move forwards. I'm not this. I'm a better person. I want to live a better life. And this is not who I am. This is not who I wanted to be. And this is not who I will be. Once we make this determination, and confronting our stupidity can invigorate us to make that determination, then we can situate ourselves on the spiritual platform and access Krishna's mercy wholeheartedly and start growing spiritually. So the Bhagavad-Gita says, when we use our intelligence to situate ourselves on the spiritual platform, evam buddhe param buddhva samsthabhyatmanam atmana jahi shatrum mahabaho kamarupam durasadam. The self-destructive desire that has tormented us for so long, we can actually break free from it when we use our intelligence to see it for what it is and to see ourselves as spiritual and become resolved to connect with the Supreme Spiritual Reality and reclaim our spirituality. Thank you. Hare Krishna.